गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई पूर्णिमा वेलकम यू टू माई क्लास एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू ए न्यू लेसन रिटन बाई के ए अब्बास एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज होली. सो द राइटर इज के ए अब्बास इज द राइटर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड बी telling you something about the writer, then the theme, and of course then we will be discussing the whole lesson. So K.A. Abbas, his full name is Khwaja Ahmad Abbas. He was a famous Indian film director, novelist, screenwriter, and a journalist in Urdu, Hindi, and English languages. He was the filmmaker like Saath Hindustani, which was released in 1969, Do Boon Pani, which won the National Film Award for Best Feature Film on National Integration. He wrote screen scripts of the best of Raj Kapoor films like Awara, Shri 420. We all know, children, these are the most hit film of India and directed by Raj Kapoor. Okay, Shri 420, Awara, Mera Naam Joker, and Bobby. He was born in the family of the famous Urdu poet Hali, who was a student of Mirza Ghalib. His grandfather was one of the chief rebels of the 1857 First War of Independence. He was born in Panipat, Haryana on 7 June 1914 and died on 1st June 1987 at the age of 72 in Mumbai. This is all about the author K.A. Abbas, that is Khwaja Ahmad Abbas, and in fact he was one of the most famous director of the Indian movie. Okay, blessed with Urdu, Hindi, and English languages, and made lot of films like Saath Hindustani in 1969, Do Boon Pani, which won the National Film Award for Best Feature Film on National Integration, and of course, children, he wrote script of the best of Raj Kapoor film like Awara, Shri 420, Mera Naam Joker, and Bobby. So, children, this is all about the writer. So, this is written by this famous writer Holi. Now I will be doing the explanation of the lesson, and then we will be doing the theme. Okay. So Holi is a very nice and motivational story. So Holi is the simpleton. So I will be explaining you the lesson point wise. So, Holi the simpleton. My first point is Holi the simpleton. Children, simpleton means a stupid person. So, Holi was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. So he was having many daughters, and she was the fourth daughter of Nambardar Ramlal. She had fallen off the cot when she was just 10 months old. So when she was a baby, she was only 10 months old, she had fallen from the cot. Some part of her brain was damaged, and due to that some part of the brain was damaged. Out of all children, only she remained backward. So children, all the children were quite smart, okay, but she remained backward. Therefore she was called Holi the simpleton. She was called Holi the simpleton. Okay, now my second point is pock marks all over the body of polio. Pock marks all over the body. So there were pock marks all over the body of Bholi. At birth, Bholi was very fair and pretty. When she was 2 years old, she had an attack of smallpox. So children, Bholi was very fair and she was a very pretty girl. But when she was born, two years old, she had an attack of smallpox. Her eyes were saved, but her entire body was disfigured. So her whole body was disfigured. She had deep black pock marks all over the body. So what was the matter, children? She had a deep pock marks all over the body. Little Sulekha. So children, actually Bholi name was Sulekha. Little Sulekha, now everybody called her Bholi. Learn how to speak at 5. So when she was 5 years old, she learned how to speak. She stammered. That means she was not able to speak properly. Very slowly, by stopping at many letters, she was speaking. Children often made fun of her. And children, she was made fun. Children often made fun. She stammered. Children often made fun of her. So Bholi talked very little. Okay, so all the children, they used to make fun of her because she was stammering, and children, everybody used to laugh at her. So she was the one who did not like, nobody liked everybody laughing at on him or her. But she talked very little. Now, 7 children in the family. My this point is, there were 7 children in the family. Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters. Bholi was the youngest. It was a prosperous family. There was plenty to eat and drink. Every child was healthy except Bholi. So that was a prosperous family. And total Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters. Bholi was the youngest daughter. It was a prosperous family. There was plenty to eat and drink. Every child was healthy except Bholi. The sons were sent to study in the city. Radha was already married. Mangala marriage had been fixed. So children, the sons were sent to for studies in the city. Radha, the eldest, was already married. Mangala marriage had been fixed. The third one was Champa. All the girls except Bholi were good looking and healthy. So all the girls, they were good looking and healthy. There was no difficulty in marrying them. Ramlal was worried about Bholi. She had neither good looks nor intelligent. So children, everybody, Ramlal knew that all his 3 daughters, they were quite good enough to get married. Except Bholi, she had neither good looks nor intelligent. Okay, now children, Bholi was sent to village school. This is my next point, that Bholi was sent to the village school. A primary school was opened in the village. The tehsildar came to perform its opening ceremony. He asked Ram Lal to set an example and sent all his daughters to school. He had no courage to disorder the tehsildar. The next day, he caught Bholi by the hand and took her to school. She was frightened and shouted in terror. Bholi was lucky to receive a clean dress that no longer fitted Champa. She was bathed and oil was rubbed in her matted hair. Bholi now begins to think that school was a better place than home. Okay, so at first she was afraid to go there, but later on she realized that school was much better place than home. Children, finally what happened? Bholi was sent to school that was recently opened, and the tehsildar came to perform in his opening ceremony. He asked Ram Lal to set an example and sent all his daughter to school. He had no courage to disobey the tehsildar. Now the next day, he caught Bholi by the hand and took her to school. She was frightened and shouted in terror. Bholi was lucky to receive a clean dress that no longer fitted Champa. She was bathed and oil was rubbed into her matty hair. Bholi now began to think that school is much better than home. Kind-hearted teacher. There she met a teacher. Okay, and Bholi was glad to find so many girls there. They were almost of her age. She hoped that one of these girls might become her friend. Bholi was impressed by the pictures of birds and animals on the wall. The teacher came to her and asked her name. She stammered again and again but could not pronounce her full name. The teacher encouraged her. She decided to make another effort. At this time, she succeeded in pronouncing her full name. Bholi. The teacher patted her affectionately. She assured her that she would be able to speak like everyone else soon. She asked her to come to school every day. She said, yes. Bholi was herself surprised that she had been able to say this. The teacher assured her that within a month she would be able to read the picture book. In time, she would be more learned than anyone else in the village. Then no one would be able to laugh at her. Bholi's heart was throbbing with a new hope and a new life. Okay, so children, it was a teacher who assured her that within a month, if she would be practiced, she would be able to read the picture book and then anyone else in the village, and nobody will able to laugh at her, and this encouraged Bholi to learn. Now Bholi's marriage plan. At last, an offer came from a well-to-do bridegroom for Bholi. Now children, finally, after some time, a well-to-do bridegroom was there and he wanted to marry Bholi. He had a big shop, a house of his own and several thousand in bank. He was not asking for dowry. The bridegroom was almost the age of Bholi's father. And he also limped. So he was limping. And his age, he was a very aged person, like his father's age. And they were children from his first wife, were quite grown up. These things did not matter to Bholi's parents. They were happy that she was at least going to be get married. Holi's wedding day. Now children, finally the day had come. So I'm going to explain now my 7 point. Holi's wedding day. Okay. Finally, children, Bishambarnath, the bridegroom of Holi, was a prosperous grocer. He came with a big party of friends and relatives. A brass band was playing a popular filmy tune. Ramlal was overjoyed to see such a pomp and splendor. Holi's elder sister were jealous of her love. Garlanding and a quick glance of Holi. Garlanding and a quick glance of Holi. Okay, well, he came the bridegroom. The bridegroom lifted the garland of a yellow marigold. A woman slipped back the silken veil of Holi. Bishambar looked a quick glance. The garland remained poised in his hand. He cried that she had pock marks in her face. If he was to marry her, her father must give him 5,000 rupees as dowry. So children, when he saw the pock marks all over her face, he told his father, I will not marry unless he will give me 5,000 rupees. Ramlal placed his turban at Bishambar's feet. He was ready to pay 2,000 rupees. The bridegroom did not budge from 5,000. At last, Ramlal went in and opened his safe and counted the notes. He placed the bundle of notes on Bishambar's feet. The greedy Bishambar had a triumphant smile on his face. He was ready to garland the bride. Okay, and then suddenly what happened? Let's see. Holi threw away the marriage garland. Okay, so what did? She threw away the marriage garland into the fire. See what the brave girl had done. Okay. So, before Bishambar could garland her, Holi hand stuck out like a streak of lightning and the garland was flung into the fire. She got up and threw away the veil. All her relatives and her parents were stunned to hear her speak without stammering. Holi asked her father to take the money back. Ramlal called her crazy and she wanted to disgrace the family. So children, Holi got up and threw away the veil. All her relatives and her parents were stunned to hear her speak without stammering. Holi asked her father to take the money back. Ramlal called her crazy and she wanted to disgrace the family. Holi replied that she would not have such a mean and greedy man as her husband. So she straight away told that she is not going to have such a greedy man as her husband. Bishambarnath started to go back with his party. Ramlal turned to Holi and asked her what she would do, as no one would ever marry her. Sulekha. Now children, Holi was called Sulekha, said in a firm voice that they did not need to worry about her. She would serve her father and mother in their old age. She told that she is going to serve her father and mother in their old age. She would teach in the same school where she had learned so much. Bholi teacher had been watching the drama standing in a corner. She said, "Yes, Bholi, of course." So children, see what that brave girl, how she faced everything. And now children, what is the message of the story is that, children, that a girl has to be bold, okay? Bholi replied that she would serve her parents in the old age and teach in the same school from where she had learned much. Her teacher was seeing the whole drama standing in a corner, agreed with Bholi and said, "Yes, Bholi, of course." Okay, so children, now I would like to discuss the theme or the message of this wonderful story. Bholi is the story of a village girl who was discriminated. As she had pock marks on her face, stammered and was considered to be simpleton. Bholi suffered an attack of smallpox when she was just 2 years old. She damaged a part of her brain when she fell off from the cot. Education transformed a dumb cow into a fearless and courageous girl. First, she agreed to marry an unequal match, Vishambar, just to maintain the honor of the family. Her father, Lamlal, put even his turban at the feet of the greedy bridegroom. He expected to marry with a pockmark only after getting 5,000 rupees as dowry. Bholi showed the courage of throwing away the ceremonial garland into the fire. She refused to have such a mean man as her husband, who was not only greedy and contemptible coward like Vishambarnath. She was not only greedy, but he was very much coward person. So children, the message is that if any drawback is there in any of the girl, she could equalize that drawback by getting the education. So Bholi, though she was having a pock mark, she used to stammer. Okay, she was thought to be simpleton, and she went to the school where teacher also encouraged her. And children, she was the one who refused to marry a greedy and mean person, decided to serve old parents and teach in the same school. Okay. Now, so this was a beautiful story of Bholi, and the teacher was a great person here, children, who supported Bholi. Okay. The teacher had all along stood there in a corner. She had been watching the whole drama. She also heard Bholi saying that she would teach in the same school where she had learned so much. Bholi turned to teacher for affirmation. The teacher replied, "Yes, Bholi, of course." She felt as if her mission had been completed. Okay. So, we have completed this lesson. Okay. And children, girls like Bholi who are bold, and no girls in the Indian family where a lot of drawbacks are there, they do like that, like throwing the ceremonial garland into the fire, but Bholi had done that. So earlier Bholi could not oppose the proposal as she wanted to save the honor of the family, but now enough was enough. Vishambar had no regard and respect for her parents. He was ready to marry her for 5,000 rupees. When he moved forward to garland her, she threw the wedding garland away into the fire. She declared that she would not have such a mean, greedy and cowardly person as her husband. So children, this was the reaction of Bholi when Vishambarnath demanded of 5,000 rupees to marry Bholi. Okay. And her father went and he gave out 5,000 rupees. Ramlal went and placed his turban at Vishambar's feet. He begged him not to humiliate him in that manner. He was ready to give 1,000-2,000 rupees, but Bissam Padnaud did not budge. Ram Lal went inside and came back with the money and placed the bundle of notes at Bishambar's feet. Okay, so now you can see that Ram Lal stood silently rooted to the ground. His head bowed with the weight of grief and sorrow. He turned the poli and asked what would happen to her now. No one would ever marry her. Yes, what shall we do with you? Now, when a great father asked poli like that, then children, what if poli told? See her braveness. See how nicely she had turned this matter into happiness. When her grieved father showed her anxiety about her still unmarried daughter, Boli replied calmly and steadily. He asked her father not to worry about her. She assured that she would serve him and her mother in their old age, and she also told that she would teach in the same school where she had also learned so much. The teacher was very much happy, and she, children, told Boli that she could do that. Okay, so the Boli was frightened to go to school. Why she was frightened? No girl in the family had ever gone to the school. The next day when Ram Lal held her hand to take her to school, Boli was really frightened that day, and she did not know what a school was. She thought that perhaps her parents were punishing her by sending her to school. So she cried in terror and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. Okay, and children, lot of preparation were also made. This question can also come, what preparation were made for Boli to send her in the school. So Ram Lal asked his wife to arrange some decent clothes for Boli. He did not want the teacher and other schoolgirls to make any bad image of the family. So this was all done to avoid the bad image of the family, not to support the Boli, but to gain the honor of the family. This was being done. Therefore Boli was lucky to get a clean dress, and that clean dress belonged not to Boli, it belongs to Champa, who became healthier and the dress became out of size, and that's why that dress was given to Boli. Boli was given bath, oil was rubbed into her dry and matted hair. Only then Boli began to think that she was going to a better place than to her home. Now children, when Boli went to the school for the first time, she was really afraid, but then later she did enjoy it. And Ram Lal handed over Boli to the headmistress. She asked Boli to sit down in a corner in one of the classes. Boli was glad to find so many girls of her age in the class. She hoped to make one of them her friend. She could not understand what the teacher was saying. She liked the picture of bird and animal on the wall. The teacher asked her name, but Boli could not pronounce it in spite of many efforts. The kind and friendly teacher encouraged her, and Boli could say, "Bha bha Boli." The teacher patted her on her success. Boli felt comforted and relieved. Then children, how did this type of question may also come? This is from the sample paper. How did teacher help Boli to pronounce her name full and clearly? So the teacher asked Boli to tell her name. She could stammer "Bha bha Boli." Only she began to cry, and tears rolled down her eyes. Girls started laughing at her, but the teacher comforted her. Her voice was very soothing. She made another effort but failed. The teacher encouraged her, and Boli made the last effort and spoke "Bha bha bha Boli." She was relieved, as if it was a great achievement when she has pronounced Boli, the full word Boli. The teacher patted her on her success. And what is she, the teacher told to Boli? "In time, you will more learn it than anyone else in the village." said the teacher to Poli. What was the basis of reposing such a confidence in a girl who could not even pronounce her name properly? Poli stammered and could not even pronounce her full name to the teacher. The teacher succeeded and made her speak Baba Poli. Poli, she asked her to come to school every day. The teacher gave her a picture book and hoped that she would finish it within a month. In time, she would be more learned than anyone else in the village. Then no one would ever be able to laugh at her. So children, this is all about Poli, and we can feel that how important is the education for the girls. So now I conclude my lesson here. Thank you and have a nice day. Good day.